Pepe, no, we're not exactly playing Fortnite. We're playing Rocket Racing, which I'm trying to understand whether like it's worth this will be the first time that I've ever like booted up for Fortnite in this game, like for any reason. I'm a bit concerned that it already knows I'm black, or it assumed I'm black. But first, I need to check the fucking settings, man. Like, where is the... How can I... Ah, praise the Lord. It actually knows that I'm using a PS5 controller. So many games were like, I actually. XZD. Yeah. Yeah, I play on ultra wide, so that's how it is. So are these so confusing? Seems like with DLSS, the max it can get to is 4 is 120. Yeah, it's a loud guy. I'm gonna snap. So can I edit my profile or what? Is that not an option? Do I have to be the black guy? Man, what a weird UI. So I guess that's just my, like, avatar. I guess, maybe. So there's no brake taps, it doesn't seem like. Okay, this is cool. Messed up there. Oh, that's how that works. Interesting. Okay. And then air dodge up. And then air dodge down again. Yeah. Okay, so that's the drifting. Yeah, so just full steam. Interesting, some avatar changes again. I think for a game like Fortnite, I'd rather have everything on high. I guess now I can just play all the tracks. It looks like you have to drift to build speed in any case. But then drifting. Wait, what the hell? I got scammed. How does that work? I literally started. Yeah, so you always want full steering on that. Interesting. Third after missing the sights. Kind of missing, I guess. drifting to gain speed by stressing out is like interesting. To start drifts is like important, I guess. That was a better drift. Interesting, he always wants to be at the outside. Okay, another podium. Not bad. interesting first rift. Wow. Holy moly. That was a good race. Oh yeah, exactly. It's literally just Fortnite, and like everything about it is, oh yeah, Merry Christmas as well. I was in focus, so I didn't see the messages. Yeah, it seems like it's weird because I don't know if Rocket League uses Unreal Engine or not, but it seems like there's a lot of integration between this game and Rocket League, where it's like if you can carry over skins and stuff like that, and like the fundamental driving controls are the same. But other than that, everything about the graphics and stuff is still just Fortnite. But it's kind of interesting for a racing game. It's not really... There's some skill that it asks you to do, but like you can't really brake. All that it wants you to do is just keep drifting and just build speed. And it's like... It's not like track meaning where you're going point to point. It's always like circus tracks, like with three laps. So that's a very interesting contrast. Oh, okay, that makes sense. Yeah, I just always want to drift. What are these frame drops, game? It's not the... Oh, that was bad. Okay, now I know what to do for the second lap at least. Oh, there's a hidden booster at the... if you jump there. Oh, you can go upside down there. That's interesting. Yeah, those are the boosters I missed. Interesting. Ah, that was bad. I got sniped. Oh yeah, Dauntless is cool. Dauntless is cool. It's like, it's basically like Fortnite as well. But it's very, it's very it's not nearly as methodical as Monster Hunter. Like the fighting the monster isn't really the important part. It's more like the loot. Like actually fighting the monster isn't really, like, it's tough. Like the gameplay isn't like easy, but like it's not really the, like, fighting is not really the hardest thing to do. Like, it's more like the... it's very interesting. It's like the environments are very Fortnite-like. And, like, you have, like, shields and the skills and stuff. It's hard to describe unless you try it for yourself. But it's very much like Monster Hunter Fortnite. And it's like, it also has a battle pass. But, like, the actual gameplay is kind of like, it's good at hooking you. Yeah, it's good at hooking you. It's like, it can take you on pace because it's not really like a story. So you're just like, okay, I guess today I'm just going to hunt like one or two things and then leave. But then, yeah, it's other than that, it's very, yeah, but it's not that bad. I was surprised I played it as much as I did. Like, I've played it like 5 or 6 times now for at least 2 hours. So decent amount of time spent playing it. And like, I'm like at level, there's not like hunter rank, it's just the weapon level. And as you level up the weapon, you do more damage, and then you can unlock like stronger monsters and stuff too. And then you have to unlock different new masks from like the skill tree, things like that. So like it's interesting, but yeah, I think it's a type of game where like it doesn't really do the same thing that Wild Hearts or Monster Hunter does. It's kind of like, it's more Fortnite like. It's more like a game that you just turn your brain off, play with friends, just hunt whatever spawns on the map endlessly, just get loot, make weapons. But it's just like there's not really hunts are not supposed to last like 20-30 minutes the way they do in Monster Hunter. We're chasing them above the map. This one, monsters are mostly in one location and they just do a lot of like high damage moves. So it's just about managing the monster's moves, making sure that you can chip the health down, and then like just killing it, getting the loot you need. And there's like events. It's very Fortnite. Like, I just keep coming back to Fortnite because that's the only really way to describe it properly. It's just very much Fortnite. So there's no, you're not going to be chasing the monster around the map. There's just a set map you enter into, you airlift, like you take the first science bus, you land there, and then as you run around, monsters just keep on spawning, you go and kill them. If you want, you can play by yourself. If you want, you can spawn with people, and then you can just go attack something. There are monsters that are higher level than you, there are monsters that are lower level than you, and then depending on that, to get XP, you get, and you're always trying to look for XP to improve your weapons. And the weapons, I only tried like the type of like glaive, inside glaive, like the combos are not that, there's not that much depth to the combats. It's not like Monster Hunter World where, yeah, it's like an arena fight but larger, where it's like, it's basically like the Guiding Lands. That's just how it is. It's like you just enter there and then monsters are just running, so you can just go wherever. But it's like, yeah, the combats, there's not that much depth to it. It's like the things that are there, you're supposed to fight them, but you're not supposed to like be fighting with the controls. It's like you have like one, you have two buttons, you have like two main combos, and that's it. And so it's like, yeah, it's mostly. After I've played this, I might switch to like one more race here, and I might switch to Dauntless. And I'll just clip the two different highlights into two different VODs. I just wanted to try out this game because I'm just like, wait, Fortnite has a racing game now? That's crazy. Let me see what it's like. And it's like decently fun. I've never played Fortnite on this computer before, so interesting install. I think Fortnite now is like 60 gigs, which is like insane because there's no reason why a game like Fortnite should be that big. I don't know what they're putting inside this game, except it's more skins. But yeah, 60 gigs is a lot. Doesn't look like there's another game, so I might just quit now.